Hare Krishna. Even if we can't change what we live with, we can change what we live for. Often, when our situations are difficult, our situations are disempowering, our situations are discouraging, we start feeling resentful about them and we start feeling powerless, helpless. And sometimes it's true that situations are such that we can't change them. We can talk a lot about how determination and willpower and all those things, but there are certain things which are just unchangeable no matter how much determination and willpower we exercise. So there are some battles that are already lost, and to fight that battle that are already lost is to stay lost. So in such situations, when we feel helpless and powerless, we need some sense of purpose and power and progress. This is the direction I can go and I want to go. So how do we do that? By recognizing that actually each one of us is a soul who is a part of God, and we are meant not just to enjoy the pleasures that come from our material situations, but we are meant to relish the supreme pleasure that comes from our spiritual evolution and our spiritual connection with the supreme reality, Krishna. So that higher connection and the satisfaction it brings can empower us. And if we live in every situation for establishing that connection, then we can have purpose which transcends our situations. So for example, if we are working in some situation where we are not getting any results at the external physical level, things are not changing and we can't change anything about it. Say we are working somewhere and we are just not being appreciated. Then if we have to work over there, we may not want to be in that situation. We can't change that situation. We can change what we live for. So we can live for Krishna and live for Krishna's purpose for us. And if we focus on our spiritual evolution, then we always have something to live for. And that's how Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita in 1858, Machittaha sarvadurgani matprasadat tarishyasi atha chetvam ahankara nashroshyasi vinangshyasi. That if you become conscious of me, you will pass over all obstacles by my grace. If, however, out of ego you refuse to act in my consciousness, then you will be lost, you will be destroyed. What this essentially means is Krishna is urging us to not just be conscious of him as a remote object existing in some other world, but as the all-attractive Supreme Person, connection with whom and through service can give us satisfaction and meaning in every situation in our life. And if we thus act purposefully in the mood of service, the very nature of the world is nothing is permanent and things can change. Krishna can change things for the better. Or through those difficult situations, we grow if we don't give in to depression and negativity. And thus, we may even be able to change the things around us. Even if so, we might even be able to change the things we live with. But even if we can't, changing the things we live for can change our life always. Thank you. Hare Krishna.